So I am back again with another video, Dave Firestone. And the footage you're seeing is of Fallout 2 stunts. I'm going to be using this as my story time and background game footage from here on out because it's fun, it's easy to do, and it always looks good. And I say this because we're going to be talking about the coin game today. Because I tried for this video to get the best footage I could, no matter what combination of stuff I tried, I just couldn't get it to look good as it could be. So, yeah, I will be showing you gameplay footage. It will be sped up heavily. I really don't think you want to sit through 5 hours anyway, so let's get on with this. So I'm going to be playing the four coin pushers in the coin game, which is an arcade simulator where you can go to three different arcades, play games there. You can go to a carnival, play games there. You can shoot off fireworks. It's just a lot of fun. Now, it has birthday mode and survival mode. Birthday mode is where you're basically, you don't have to worry about getting money. You start with 200 bucks, and if you want more money, you can always go into the money booth. You can get like 40 or 50 or 60 bucks per shot. And it's just a lot of fun. So we're going to be playing a full round of birthday mode for each coin pusher. Each will be independent of the other. We're going to start with $200. We're going to spend all of it in one go on coin pushers. And we'll see which one gives you the best bang for your buck. Now, there are four coin pushers in total, two at Larry's Arcade, Cuckoo Coins and Dunko. And at the UFO Arcade Raceway and Fun Center, you have Popcorn Pete and Friends and Mermaids from Space. We're going to start at Larry's Arcade, and we're going to be playing Cuckoo Coins first. And it's sort of a combination of real money and The Price is Right. Because how it works is you have to maneuver the coins through the boxes that say coin, and the light turns, if a light is on when the coin goes through, the letter lights up, and if you light all five letters, you spin to get tickets. Now, this is a real money coin pusher, so you do get money back from the various prizes that fall off the ledge. So we're going to play twenty $10 rounds, and we'll see how much we get, both in terms of tickets and money back. Thank you.
Thank you.
So Cuckoo Coins was pretty generous to us. We got 12,197 tickets, which isn't really a lot to sneeze at, but we also got $172.50 back after spending $200 on the coin pusher. So you do get a lot of bang for your buck there. We're going to stay in Larry's Arcade, this time moving to Dunko. Now Dunko is sort of a combination of the above mentioned Price is Right and card drop coin pushers, because it's the same basic gameplay as Cuckoo Coins, but you're trying to push trading cards off the edge, and if you get all five, you get 1,000 tickets and a plush which can be exchanged for money. So we're going to try $200 on this, and we'll see how it goes. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
So on Dunko, we spent $200 and got 21,486 tickets. That's not bad. We're going to head over to the UFO Arcade Raceway and Fun Center. We're going to be trying Mermaids from Space next. Now this is based on the Flintstones Quarry Quest coin pusher where you use tokens to push tickets or tokens or I don't know what you call them. Like little cards that have various amounts off the edge, and every time you do you get a certain amount based on whatever amount the little tabs are. And then, I don't know how this works. Admittedly, I was never able to figure it out. There doesn't seem to be any information online about how it works, but there's a bonus thing, and every so often it gives you a certain number of bonus tickets. So we're going to see how many tickets we can get from this.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Thank you.
So I saved the very best for last. My favorite coin pusher in the coin game, Popcorn Pete and Friends coin pusher. Now this is clearly based on SpongeBob, and it works the same way. You slide tokens down a ramp, trying to get them through. I think they're popcorn bags that have... They're popcorn bags on a carousel, and if you get one through and into the machine, it gives you, depending on where the lights on the wheel are, it can be anywhere from 2 to 3 bonus tokens, 3 bonus plays, a bonus wheel spin, which is actually more generous than the version I played at Dave & Buster's, where instead of just giving you 4 all the time, it can give you 8 and 15 on a few occasions. And then there's the card drop. Now the card drop here is interesting because you're trying to win eight total tickets. Excuse me, 8 total cards. When you get the whole set, you get 2,000 plus a plush, which is actually very, very good in terms of redeeming it for money at the pawn shop. So let's see how we do here. And I'm gonna speed this up twice as long because this is literally 2 hours in real time, so we're going to make it half an hour instead of 15 minutes. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So we did very well on Popcorn Pete and Friends. We got 31,522 tickets for $200, which is actually pretty good. So where would I rate the four coin pushers? Well, number four obviously is Mermaids from Space. Stingiest coin pusher, not as much fun. Very needlessly complex. I don't even get the bonus system. So it's fourth out of four. Number three would be Dunko. I think it could be a little more generous, but in terms of fun, it's actually very fun, and it's pretty decent on tickets. Number two, in terms of bang for your buck, would be Cuckoo Coins. Now granted, we only got 12,197 tickets for Cuckoo Coins, but we also got back, in terms of money, $172.50 when we put in $200. So we got, not only did we get a decent amount of tickets for one particular game, we also got pretty much, and it almost all of our money back, which is pretty good. And the number one, Popcorn Pete. In terms of tickets, it's the best you can do. Yeah, so that's my analysis of the coin game Coin Pushers. I'm going to be playing this game a lot more often. I'll be streaming Flat Out 2 and occasionally Team Fortress 2, in addition to silent NASCAR footage for Driver Suit Blog Radio. But anyway, I'll figure out something fun to do for next week. I'm Dave Farsley. If you like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you then.